again, and I thought I would do a bit of a nail polish comparison type video. I've just catalogued the majority of my nail polish, and I came across some that looked kind of similar to each other, so I thought I would do a bit of a comparison. All the ones I have today are blue ones, or one of them's kind of teal-ish, but they're basically in the blue category. I have a little bit of a croaky voice, so I sound a bit weird. I have 16 nail polishes here in 4 sort of sets kind of thing. One of them, which is the first one I do, is a little bit of a stretch, but whatever. They do look different in the camera to how they look in person, just so you are aware of that. I'm also filming this at night, so you can see the reflection of my lamp in my swatch wheel. So anyway, I will get on with it, seeing as how I have quite a few of them. So the first one I'm going to look at is this Sally Hansen Triple Shine. This is in Make Waves. This is actually really, really sheer, and I'm going to compare it firstly to this Sinful Colors, which is called Aquamarine. It's also kind of on the sheer side. In the camera, the light is making a bit of a noise, but this one has more green in it than this one does, but they're both kind of tealy. So we'll see what they do and we'll come on the swatch wheel. The other two, which are kind of in the similar sort of vein in this group of four, these two, another Sinful Colors. This one is Love Nails, again a kind of sheerish bluey green, and this one is Surf Spray from Revlon's Puff Humory line, and it is kind of a, it's got that kind of same bluey green with a bit of silver in it. So I'm going to swatch each of these on the swatch wheel so we can see what they're like. So first up, we will do Make Waves from Sally Hansen, which has always looked really nice in the bottle. But as you can see, it's got this really cool green iridescence to it. As you can see, it is pretty sheer. Next, I will do Aquamarine from Sinful Colors. Helps if the lids would come off. I didn't prepare beforehand, you know, shaking them up, that kind of thing. See, this one is, has a bit more colour to it. It's not as sheer on the first coat. This is more like how I wanted Make Waves to actually be. Next we will do Love Nails, also from Sinful Colours. Sorry for my thumb getting in the way. It has a very similar, even though it's not quite as dark as Love Nails. Sorry, Aquamarine. It's got the same kind of reflect in it. They're very similar colours for something that comes from the same brand. And lastly, Revlon's Surf Spray. This one has more glitter in it. Like, the glitters are bigger. Not by a lot. Again, all of these are kind of sheer. And they are all very kind of similar. So I'll move on to the next group and then I will come back and put another coat on all of those. So the next group are kind of pale bluey greens. See, I have four of them. Okay, so the first one is the classic perennial Where's My Chauffeur from Essie. I only have a mini of it. All of these have separated really badly. Like, you can see the white and the blue and the green. And all of them, every brand of these is the same. So I'm comparing it to this one from L'Oreal. This is Not a Cloud in Sight. It's one of a couple that are numbered 111 by L'Oreal, just so you know. But as you can see in the bottle, Where's My Chauffeur might be, well, is a tiny weeny bit lighter. And next we have Barely Bluebell from Sally Hansen Complete Salon Manicure. This always looks terrible in the bottle. It looks a lot like, in the bottle looks a lot like Where's My Chauffeur in terms of how messy it looks. Color-wise, it's probably a little closer to the L'Oreal. I've learned not to trust what it does in the bottle. And the last one is also another Sally Hansen. This one's probably not 100% fair comparison because it's textured polish and the others are all just straight creams. And it's probably, it's definitely darker than Where's My Chauffeur. But it's pretty close to the other Sally Hansen. So we will swatch these. First we will do Where's My Chauffeur, which is not my favourite Essie. I don't really think it's got a very good formula, personally. So that is one coat of that. And then we will do the L'Oreal. Straight off, I can tell you the L'Oreal is a much thinner formula and it has more green in it, which might not be as easy for you guys to see in the camera. I won't actually be able to tell until I edit it because it always looks different. Whoops, it always looks different through the viewfinder than it does for you guys. So this is the Sally Hansen Complete Salon Manicure. This is a much more opaque formula. This is almost a one coat formula. And it is a lot more green, really, than Where's My Chauffeur. Definitely a much better formula than the other two. I mean, that is virtually opaque in one coat. And lastly, I didn't tell you what the name of this one was. It's called Plush. So this is much more green, much darker than the other three. And again, it has a better formula than these two here, but not a better formula than this one. It's going to need two coats, and you can already see it drying down and the texture starting to show. Might not be as obvious to you guys, but it's obvious to me. So the next four are a lot more blue. Again, I have two Sally Hansen's. We will start with the OPI. This OPI is Susie Says Feng Shui. If it would focus. Come on. Okay. This is one of my newer polishes. It is kind of a dusty-ish blue. Touch of green in it. It's new for me, but it looks messy in the bottle. Then we have, from Maybelline Colour Show, this is Babe It's Blue. And again, it's kind of a dusty... See, they're very, very similar. This one, that OPI might be just a little bit lighter. Then we have from Sally Hansen, from the Extreme Wear line, we have Blew Me Away. Which is nothing like Pacific Blue, in case you were wondering. But it is quite similar to the Maybelline Colour Show. Maybe a bit darker. And again, similar to the OPI. And lastly, also from Sally Hansen, we have The Sky's the Limit, which is from the Complete Salon Manicure line. Blew Me Away is maybe darker. In person, it kind of looks a little bit darker. Probably brighter than the OPI, slightly, and slightly lighter than the Maybelline Colour Show. But we will swatch and see what we get. So the OPI. Susie Says Feng Shui. Not the best formula, I has to say. Next we will do Babe It's Blue from Maybelline Colour Show. This is a slightly thinner formula, but and it's a bit lighter than the OPI, but it went on, like it was easier to apply. Then Blew Me Away. Sorry, I'm shaking bottles if you're wondering. Blew Me Away from Sally Hansen. Again, this is a more sheer polish. Bit more green in it than the Maybelline, and definitely lighter than the OPI. And The Sky's the Limit, also from Sally Hansen. Much better formula than the others. Much easier to use. Really like the Complete Salon Manicure line. It is more blue than Blew Me Away is, which has a touch of green in it. And it's definitely lighter than these two over here. Not by a lot. But they all might look somewhat different after a second coat, which is what I usually find. So the last four are the reason that I decided to do this. I was going through my dark blues. I found a whole bunch of them that have this same kind of glitter in them. And I started with this one, which is Super Powered from Revlon, which is from the Spider-Man collection. It really doesn't want to focus properly. It's a almost dark blue, but it's got kind of this, it's not really showing up in the camera, it's kind of got like a reddy coloured fleck in it. And as I was going through my other polishes, I came across this Essence one, which is called Indigo to Go, and it has a very similar red fleck in it, which again does not really want to show in the camera. Next to each other, you can see that the glitter in this is more dense and bigger. It's a lot more sparse in this one. The colours are pretty similar. And then I found this one, which is called Midnight Blue from BYS, which is a brand that we get in Australia. And again, it's this darkish blue with a red fleck in it. It's pretty similar to the Essence one, and again, maybe a little bit darker than the Revlon one. Is probably the lightest of the four that I've got here. And the last one is from W7, which is an English brand, and the red fleck is not as noticeable in this one, but it is definitely there. I found another couple of polishes I've got that have sort of got the similar thing, but their blue is very different. This one's blue is more similar to these. Again, the glitter in this one is probably more like the one in the Essence one, but the red in it isn't quite as obvious. It's only there every now and then. This is also, it's called Dawn Raider. These are really, really good value for money. I think they're like $2.99 or something at Chemist Warehouse in Australia. And their range is like massive. And yes, they do look exactly like an OPI bottle. The only difference is that these don't have OPI on the top. Sometimes they have a 7 thing on top of them. This one doesn't, but some of them do. But they do look a lot like an OPI bottle from a distance, unless you know what you're looking at. So we will swatch these. I'll start with Super Powered. I really, really like the Spider-Man line from Revlon. I wish I'd got all of it, but I only have 2 of them. They're kind of on my wish list. Probably won't be able to get them, and they're kind of hard to get hold of. There's a lot of green in Super Powered. And that red fleck is really not showing up. Next, I will do the Essence Indigo to Go. This is much more blue, but there's still a lot of green in it. And yes, these Essence bottles look a lot like the Maybelline Colour Show bottles. Another one that you have to check, because they are virtually identical from the top. You have to check them. Actually pretty similar on the swatch. pretty similar. Next, I'll do the BYS, which you won't pretty much be able to get anywhere but in Australia that I know of. I've never seen anybody outside Australia even mention it. It's actually pretty good value for money. It's, depending on where you buy it, it's about $4 a bottle. Most of the formulas are excellent. My favourite black comes from this range. This one has come out a lot more dark blue, like navy blue, than the others, even though it doesn't look like that in the bottle. It's so pretty looking on all of those swatches. And lastly, Dawn Raider from W7. This is much, much more glittery. The glitters are much more dense and much bigger. This is actually going to be quite a textured finish. The blue has a lot less green in it too. So these two are virtually like completely different, but these two here are actually pretty similar. So we will go back around. Oh, I just stuck my finger in it. Good job, look at that. Nice thumbprint. Okay, so Make Waves from Sally Hansen Triple Shine. This is one of those ones that you either need to put it over a base, like a white base, or you have to put like four coats on. I've put a really thick coat on because it is just, it's super sheer. So now it's looking a lot more like the Zenful colours. So this one is Aquamarine from Zenful Colours. Yeah, it's much darker. That second coat really makes it look a lot darker. A similar reflex to it, and similar shimmer. But the Zenful Colours is much darker. It's also a much better formula. Nowhere near as sheer. I don't feel like I need to put an undie under it. Whereas Make Waves, I always feel like I need to put down a white or a blue or something. This one is Love Nails. Also from Zenful Colours. This one is sheerer than Aquamarine. Kind of another one that you probably need like three coats or the like an undie almost to make it look right, but it is ridiculously similar. I mean, the Aquamarine is darker and a bit more green, but they are quite similar really. And lastly, we have Surf Spray from Revlon. Again, another one which feels like it would benefit hugely from an undie. It's in fact so much like Make Waves, it's not funny in terms of its formula, but it's got glitter particles in it that the others don't have. Well, that's the main thing I'm noticing. Sorry if I keep going out of camera. So, that one's Make Waves. That one is Aquamarine. That one is Love Nails. And that one is Surf Spray. So, whilst they're similar, they're certainly none of them are dupes for each other. But formula-wise, I would go for either of the two Zenful Colours over the Revlon and the Sally Hansen. These just have such better formula, and they're a better price, quite frankly. And you get the same kind of look for a much better price. So, that's those ones. Let's move on to the next ones. We have Where's My Chauffeur from Essie. I really don't like this formula. This is one of the ones that's in my mini collection to eventually use up this year. That's two coats. It's bloody patchy. I don't know if you can actually tell, but it's patchy. Do not like. Not a Cloud in Sight from L'Oreal. It is lighter than Where's My Chauffeur. not a lot lighter, just a little bit lighter. But its formula is considerably better. So that's not a cloud in sight. That's Where's My Chauffeur. This one is so patchy. This one is not. Their colours are actually super similar. A bit more blue in this, a bit more green in this. But other than that, I would go for the L'Oreal. I don't know if you can get those ones anymore. But that L'Oreal is so much better than Where's My Chauffeur. Next we have Barely Bluebell from Sally Hansen, which pretty much doesn't even need a second coat. I'm only doing it for consistency's sake. I always have difficulty with the second coat with Sally Hansen for some reason. Don't ask me why, because I don't know. It is more, it's like a lighter version of the L'Oreal one. They're quite similar, but this is definitely lighter. The L'Oreal one's just a touch duskier in tone. It's much closer to, the L'Oreal is much closer to the Essie, Where's My Chauffeur. This one is a lot more bright and light than that one. And lastly, we have Plush from Sally Hansen, which I noticed as it dried actually lightened. As I said, it is a textured polish. Finish is almost matte. So there, it looks a lot darker. And it is a lot darker than the others and a lot more green than the other three. In terms of formula, I would either go for Complete Salon Manicure, which is that one, or the L'Oreal. Their formula is so much better than the Essie one. So much easier to apply. I think the colour's slightly better, personally. You can see this one drying down. You can see the colour changing, but it's still not going to be as light as these three are. So that is those four. Again, no real dupes. These two are pretty close, but they're not the same. They're not exactly the same colour. Now on to the next ones. We have the OPI, Susie Says Feng Shui. Which in two coats becomes quite dark in colour. It's actually not a bad formula, that one. Quite like that. Next we have Maybelline's Colour Show in Babe It's Blue. Much, much lighter than the OPI. Lovely formula though. Lovely nail polish. I like that one. And on sale, you can get Maybelline Colour Show for less than $4 a bottle. Depending on where you buy it from, of course. But quite like Babe It's Blue. It's looking really nice. Sally Hansen's Blew Me Away. Blew Me Away and Babe It's Blue are quite similar. The Blew Me Away from Sally Hansen is maybe a touch more green, and the Maybelline is maybe a touch brighter. They're not exactly the same. They are very similar though. I don't know that you could necessarily justify having both of them. I can justify having both of them. But they are ever so slightly different. Those of us who are addicted will be able to see the difference quite easily. This is a lighter, quite frankly. And lastly, in that set, we have The Sky's the Limit, also from Sally Hansen, but from the Complete Salon Manicure line. It is much, much lighter in colour than the others. So again, four of them that maybe in the same colour vein, they're all blue, but not no dupes in there. These two are very, very similar. The Maybelline Babe It's Blue and Sally Hansen Blew Me Away, but they're not, definitely not the same. Which brings us to the last four, starting with Superpowered from Revlon, from the Superman collection. So this is one of those ones, put on the second coat, it looks like a completely different colour. The green basically goes away. Still can't, in person I can see a bit of the red reflect, but it's not, doesn't seem to be showing up in the camera. So next we have the Essence Indigo To Go. That brings its colour much closer to that of Superpowered, but it makes the glitter obvious, that the glitter in the Essence one is actually slightly bigger and there's more of it. It just makes it more obvious that that's actually the case. They are very similar though. This one is more blue, this still has more of a touch of green to it. But they are quite similar. I actually prefer, even though I love Superpowered, I actually prefer the Essence one. So next we'll look at the BYS one, which on the swatch wheel there is looking very, very grey in comparison to the blues. So as you can see, it is quite a bit darker. Its red reflect is actually more obvious, like the little red flecks in it are more obvious. Maybe not to you guys, but to me, they are actually more obvious in that one than they are in the other two, even though that's what made me think they were very similar. It is quite a bit darker in colour. And more grey, it's more of a grey blue than a mid-toned blue. And lastly, the W7, which I put my thumb in, which is clearly a much much bigger glitter particles. The colour is a lot more similar after the second coat to the Essence, but it's clearly a very different kind of polish. It's more of a jelly with glitter in it, unlike these. Similar sort of colour, but it is more textured when it dries down than these ones are. These just dry smooth and shiny. But yeah, so that is all of the lovely comparisons that I have for you. You can see this Sally Hansen plush one has dried down. Actually makes it look a little bit more similar to them, like it lightens the colour slightly, but it is clearly not the same colour. So that is all of those. I hope you guys found that interesting. If you want to see me do more of these kind of videos, then just ask me to. I have a ridiculously large collection, like 850 large collection. I'm sure I have other ones that are very similar to each other in that collection. So maybe you could tell me like what colour you'd like me to look at and I can do that. So yeah, if you want to see more of my stuff, then click the subscribe button, which is down there. leave me a thumbs up if you like nail polish type videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.